Hello everyone, my name is Palamdeep Singh and I am going to talk about the business system overview in New Zealand. First we talk about the overview of the country. New Zealand is located in the Southwest Pacific Ocean. It is also known as the land of long white cloud in the Maori language. The population is approximately 4.4 million. And New Zealand is consist of two mainlands, the North Island, the South Island, and the Stewart Island. The currency of New Zealand is New Zealand dollar, and it has a mild temperature, and the temperature tends to get colder as we head south. The people of New Zealand is known as Kiwis, and the Maori people are the native population, but today New Zealand is a home to a wide range of ethnicities with growing Asian population. If we talk about the political system of the country, New Zealand raised its full independence from British in 1947, and we can see the impacts of British on the political system of New Zealand. It has a parliamentary monarchy system, which is based on the British model. It has only one house in the parliament, which is known as House of Representatives, and it has 120 seats for MPs. Most of the countries have two houses in the parliament, but New Zealand has only one house. Queen Elizabeth II is the head of the state, and are represented by Governor General in the country. New Zealand also used the system of responsible government. It means that government can made up of only those members who are first elected members of the House of Representatives. And the government can stay in the power while it has the majority of members in House of Representatives. So, the system is known as having the confidence of the house. In 1893, New Zealand became the first country to give women the right to vote. These are some economic factors. The GDP of the country is 186.4 billion US dollars. The inflation rate is 2.7% and employment rate is 4.6%. These are the main sectors in the economy and their contribution in the GDP. We can see that most of the exports of New Zealand are based on the agricultural products, but it contributes least in the GDP, that is only 4.5%. If we see in the past, New Zealand's standard of living based on its agricultural products was one of the best in the world. But after mid-20th century, the main industrial countries imposed some tariffs on its agricultural exports. So after that, New Zealand starts expanding its industrial base. So nowadays, the service sector contributes 69.7% in the GDP, and industry contributes 25.8%. These are some of the exports. New Zealand is second largest producer of sheep after Australia, and also largest supplier of wool. Some of the crops: wheat, oats, vegetables, berry fruits, tobacco, kiwi fruit, passion fruit, apple and pear are exported from the country. After agriculture, there are some forest products that are exported. This includes timber, wood pulp and chips, paper, building boards, plywood and various oils. Australia and Japan are the largest customers of forest products. industry provides employment in the country. It includes textile, leather goods, tobacco, rubber, plastic, fruit and vegetables, building supplies and furniture, light manufacturing, aircraft manufacturing, and motor vehicle assembly. Tourism is the major part of New Zealand's economy. It is a source of foreign exchange for the country, and most of the tourists come from Australia, North America, Japan, the UK, Europe, and Taiwan. The culture of the country is largely inherited from British and European customs, and it is associated with Maori and Polynesian traditions. The people of New Zealand are described as friendly but reserved, and open but respectful. Like, we can see that they are very open, but they don't like to share their personal information. These are some cultural implications in the business. First one is dress properly. The people of New Zealand has more relaxed approach to business as compared to other countries, but it is important to dress properly and formal in all the business meetings for everyone, like men and women. And we can see that as time passes, there is more room for humor and less formal talk, business talk in the meetings. Second one is be on time. If you are going to attend any meeting or event in New Zealand, then it is important to be on time. Never be late. Never lose trust of your colleagues. Trust is very important in New Zealand's culture. If somebody lost the trust of their colleagues or their boss, then it is hard to get it back. So never lose trust of your colleagues. Discrimination. Any type of discrimination on any grounds is illegal in New Zealand. Finance and banking system. The Reserve Bank of New Zealand regulates the registered banks and licensed insurers. Bank has no responsibility for non-deposit taking, non-bank lending institutions, or unlicensed insurers. The financial market of New Zealand is highly dominated by the banking sector. It accounts for approximately 94%. The government of New Zealand has ended up all of the restrictions on the number, activities, and ownership of the banks. The banking system in the country works on at your own risk policy for both, like management and the depositors. Like we can say that depositors are not covered by any insurance, but during the global financial crisis in 2008, they put in place some of the temporary guarantee arrangements. Nowadays, there are 25 registered banks in the New Zealand, and the four Australian banks, this includes ANZ, ASB, BNZ, and Westpac. These are responsible for 84% of bank lending. The legal system of New Zealand. The tax system is very simple in the country, and it is transparent and effective system. New Zealand has some of the special codes, like employment code, family code, youth code, Maori land code, to deal with different type of issues. And they also have over 100 tribunals, authorities, boards, and committees to deal with a wide range of disputes. So in the end, we'll talk about some advantages to invest in New Zealand. New Zealand has a safe and secure business environment. The World Bank ranked New Zealand first on its ease of doing business index. And the World Justice Project ranked New Zealand sixth for the quality of their justice. And Forbes rated New Zealand third best country for the business for reasons like personal freedom, investor protection, and lack of red tape and low corruption. So if anyone wants to invest in New Zealand, then we can say that it is good to invest and doing business because it is very easy to doing business and starting a business, and there is very less corruption in the country. So you can get some of the permissions very easily in this country. So this is all about the business overview of the country. Thank you.